the basic level, the rules that we have in order to do stuff on the hardware, right? You have these bits, you have these if and or flippy things you can do to the bits. You'd have to convert all your math into that.
Exactly, right? Like you're playing with these like bit strings. And imagine that you have like some number of bits. Now the possible combinations of the values of those bits, the zeros and ones, those are your bit strings. And they define your computational basis states. What a classical algorithm does is that it takes your input bit string and it permutes among those basis states. You know, for example, something that shows up very frequently and like some people use sometimes as a subroutine for many other tasks is a sorting algorithm. We're all familiar with like sorting things. So imagine that you have a sequence of numbers. You want to sort them in some increasing order, right? The input to your algorithm is the sequence of numbers that you want to solve. To sort, the output now is the sequence in the correct order. Now you have to like think about what is the set of instructions that can get me from that output from the input to the output. And a set of instructions could be, well, take adjacent numbers, say A0 and A1, compare them, then swap them if A0 is larger than A1. Right? And you can implement that comparison and the swapping instruction, all of that using these Boolean circuits. And what you're doing at the end of the day is you're permuting all of those bit strings, such that the output sequence has the right order at the end.